Welcome to 2K Sports. We have the NBA coming up. Great to have you with us. And it is still early in the season, Greg. We'd like to think we have teams figured out, but do we really?
Not at all, Kevin. This is the time period where fan bases freak out because of records. There's still a lot of identity to be found with every team.
Now let's take a look at Honolulu's opening lineup. We've got Bojan Bogdanovic. Richardson is out there with Suggs. Then it's Bridges. And it's Wagner in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. And the basket is good. Richardson's got the first points up on the board tonight here for Honolulu. To the inside. High post try. And King gets it to go on the assist by Williams.
And he's not going to miss many of those, especially that wide open.
Well, he's automatic from the mid-range, and the defense knows that. It's a mistake to give up a shot like that.
Bogdanovic with it. All guarded by Jay. Here's Suggs. He sinks the 11-footer.
Good decision there by Bogdanovic. Solid at noticing when the defense is overcommit.
And it's Barnes with the ball for Oklahoma City. And Carroll outside. Barnes passes to Bancaro. No good on the three. And here's Honolulu. Bridges, right side. There's 38 seconds left in the first quarter. Off on the lane. Barnes finds Bancaro. Ivy with it. Takes the three. A three-pointer is right on target.
He doesn't take as many threes as you think for a guard, but respectable for him.
For Honolulu, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Here's Richardson. No good that time. Good, deep by Barnes. Shane left side. And that one, good. The Bongos got his second bucket tonight.
And I like to see this. They're calling his number early, and he's delivering.
Well, he's going to just keep going now. That's early confidence for him.
And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Oklahoma City out in front. They're up by three. And we'll be back shortly for the start of the second quarter. Enjoying the game. Both teams tonight keeping things pretty even so far in the scoreboard. What stands out to you from Oklahoma City in this one?
Boy, their offense looks really good when everyone's in sync. Terrific first quarter.
They couldn't ask for a better one right now. Just a complete rhythm by all the guys who got some minutes. Wonderful start.
On the court for Honolulu, we've got Bridges. O'Neal is out there with Bagley. Then there's Jalen Noel. And it's DiVincenzo in at the shooting guard position.
Well, if the defense is going to give Bridges a lot of looks like this, he's got to continue to knock him down.
Pass to Williams. He kicks it to Ivy. His second shot goes in, off to a good start, 2-for-2.
I mean, Ivy is stronger than you might imagine with that kind of play. That's tough.
Here's Bridges. It's rebounded by Oklahoma City.
Yeah, and with most of the arena against them, they just banded together and trusted one another to make the right play.
Yeah, and in that game, it turned into a massive scoring night. It wasn't so much about the game plan as it was establishing early confidence to get that win.
Just four to shoot. Williams finds Bancaro. How good with the triple. And here's Bridges. He'll bring it up for Honolulu. It's a three-point game.
Yeah, on the road, you're already a little out of your element. Then the misses from the line become contagious.
Well, it can affect your confidence, not just as the player shooting, but the entire team. So defenses might get a little bit more aggressive, and then you got to think about the next free throw.
Here's Noel. A miss that time would have put him up.
And even though he didn't get a piece of that shot, you love the pressure he puts on the shooter.
Yeah, that's the kind of energy that you want to see on every possession throughout the game.
again. No good by Oklahoma City. To the middle. Misses the layup.
That's the only kind of defense that's going to cut the mustard here tonight. You got to stay on top of a guy like that who could play at such a high level offensively.
And some good action through the first two quarters as we reach halftime. Oklahoma City leads it by one. And join us right back here after the break for the start of the second half.
Welcome, one and all. Before we hear Kenny and Shaq's insights on that first half, let's look ahead and check out the upcoming schedule.
Taking a look here at lovely Honolulu. I think about the sunshine. I think about the weather. They're going to get tested next time out there. I'll tell you that. We'll see what they got playing a top-level team. Could be a learning moment. Could be an upset. Or both.
I think they're going to get eaten up. Their offense is too predictable right now. Getting nothing on the interior. They look like Kenny when he's running. Unbalanced.
I've got enough balance to outrun you. Let's go. Anytime.
And that is a wrap. Now let's send you back to Kevin Harlan for the start of the third quarter.
Got second half action for you, and if the next couple quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. You know, Brent, I heard you talking the other day about the advantage left-handed players have in drawing fouls. Why do you feel that's the case?
I've just always felt, Kevin, that you don't really prepare for lefties. You don't see many of them in the league. So think about it. On a Monday and a Wednesday, you're playing a squad, and all of a sudden, Thursday's back-to-back game has a guy like James Harden. It's just hard to adjust physically what you need to do in terms of defending a left-handed player.
They've got Ivy. Ben Carroll is out there with Scotty Barnes. And then there's Precious Achiuwa. And it's Kabongo in at the two-guard spot. And that's who Mark Daigneault starts the second half. First trip to the free throw line for him tonight.
First team foul.
And the biggest reason Banchero went first overall, Paolo brings your playmaking ability at 6'10". He's got a very rare skill set for that size.
Shot. Kabongo grabs the miss.
There's a little bit of pressure on him, but not enough to cause him to miss a shot that's in that close.
And now we've got some time to check in from the sideline. You got for us, D.A.
Thanks very much, everybody. Quentin Grimes is not just a 3-and-D guy. One of the best in the league at attacking the closeout. He says they know about my shooting, so that opens up my drive game. Then closing out hard, I can see if they're coming to the right side or the left side. It's read and react. Quick decisions. Kevin, my decision is to send it back to you.
All right, D.A., that's why you're in the Hall of Fame. Thank you so much.
He just takes advantage of the D in a way that very few players playing today can do.
Passes it to Bridges. Makes it off the glass.
I like seeing Josh Richardson distribute the ball, especially when his teammates are wide open. That makes for an easy pass.
Oklahoma City leading by four. Barnes outside. Richardson against Ivy. Here's Kabongo. Misses the three. For Honolulu, they've gone 2-4 here to start the second half. 2 second difference between shot clock and game clock. Knocked away. Richardson against Ivy. Richardson outside for three. No good on that one. And we've watched three so far in this one. Oklahoma City out in front, up four. And we'll have the start of the fourth quarter for you as soon as we get back from this short break. the worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them. And what a beautiful feed.
The coaches talk about it all the time, but to be able to play with that kind of feel, nice play, collaborating, improvising, and again.
Well, this has been a great contest so far. I imagine the fourth quarter could have even more action in store for us. On the court for Honolulu, Richardson is out there with Suggs. And it's Bridges. Then there's Bojan Bogdanović. And it's Wagner in at the five down low. Wagner is screen on Ivy. Here's Bridges. No good off the back of the rim.
Yeah, my expectations were that he was not going to miss that hoop. He handles that kind of defense, especially on the inside.
And you could tell he thought that triple was going to fall.
And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. Honolulu with it. Honolulu trails by six. Here's Suggs. That ball. Nice feed that time from Bogdanović.
Well, bigger than your average guard, Suggs can score all around the floor, including down low.
And it's Van Carroll missing.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he gets that open.
And pass to Suggs. Back to Richardson. Bridges inside. Covered by Barnes.
And that's a full stretch on that block by Van Carroll. Using the nerves on this guy.
Not backing down from this moment here. When the game is close, he kicks it up enough.
Here's Kabongo. And it hung on the rim, but wouldn't fall for it.
Points are an absolute must here.
Can't come away empty. That would be the nail in the coffin.
Suggs passes to Wagner.
And what can you say about Suggs? A natural born leader. Very unselfish and great vision.
Barnes kicks to Ivy. Pass to Van Carroll. It's Kabongo.
And Shannon throws it down hard. And they do have a foul.
Timeout called. Honolulu. They trail by two. We've got 13 seconds left to play in the final quarter. What's your take, guys?
Big chance here to tie it with a bucket.
Well, they just need a solid play right now, and coach going through his index cards to find one to get something going.
Here's Suggs. Richardson outside, pass to Bridges. Got it! He has tied up this game. Oh, what a shot.
Nice job getting inside for the layup. Has to be thinking jump shot again. And then off to the races.
Man, the score being this close, you have to retain possession of the ball. You just can't get away like that.
Wide open. Oh, he had a chance to win it right there, but couldn't get it to fall. And that's going to do it for regulation. So we are headed to overtime. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. Well, four quarters weren't enough to decide this ballgame. Sit back and enjoy as we move on to overtime. Out there with Mo Wagner. Then there's Richardson. Then there's Shaw. And it's Bridges in at the three spot.
This is the time when you want to lock it down defensively. Thus far, not happening.
I'm looking out there trying to find one guy at least interested in playing defense. Not that last possession.
Timeout called. Honolulu. They trailing by two. 52 seconds left in overtime. A different look for Oklahoma City. Williams comes in for a chew-up, and it's Barnes in for Markel Fultz. Butler has three on Ivy. Here's Bridges. Rebound by Williams. Barnes against Bridges. Sweet move. Bridges with the ball. And here's Bridges. They'll bring it up for Honolulu. Trailing by two.
And maybe the natural born leader that Josh Richardson is showing up in a big way.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. Shea dishes to Ivy. The kick out to Williams. Passes it to Kabaka. Off target from downtown.
Don't want to ever give up points on the boards. That's the lesson for the team there. That's a hustle play to save points.
Timeout called, Honolulu. They're down by two. 6 seconds left to play in the first overtime. What do you think, guys?
Big chance here to tie it with the Bucks. They just need a solid play right now, and coach going through his index cards to find one to get something going.
And so it's Honolulu with it. Bogdanovich passes to Richardson to win the game. So a close game sees Oklahoma City taking this one. And a straight through the draw to push it to overtime, but they really came on in the extra period.
Oh, wow. I thought he might end the regulation, but you know what? They came up big and did exactly what was necessary once we got into OT.
And that'll wrap it up, folks. So for David Aldridge, Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and the whole 2K Sports crew, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for being with us. And now we present the New Balance Player of the Game.